The truth is that on Wall Street, a lot of people just weren't very good at jobs.
It started out 16 months ago as a mortgage crisis. Then it slowly evolved into a credit crisis.
When you ask about the taxpayers being on the hook, guess what? They're already on the hook.
Restore confidence in America's economy. An unusual step for a lame duck president, but the country
claimed to be free market advocates when it's really an anything goes mentality.
On Friday, Congress finally passed and President Bush signed it.
Begin to restore strength and stability to America's financial
system. Rescue package in which the taxpayers will buy up Wall Street's bad investments.
This is a full-blown financial storm.
So in just 6 months, three of the five biggest independent firms on Wall Street have now disappeared.
The numbers are staggering. They don't begin to explain the greed and incompetence that created this mess.
No regulation, no supervision, no discipline.
A terrible debt that was magnified by reckless borrowing, complex securities.
The idea that you could lend money to someone who couldn't pay it back is not an inherently attractive idea.
I don't want these companies coming to Congress.
However, it seemed to fly with people who are making $10 million a year.
Thinking that they could take the money, do whatever they want to do.
They decide to punish the country.
This is Neel Kashkari, the man in charge of the bailout.
They're supposed to be the smartest investors in the world, and they did it themselves.
I will call it a criminal neglect.
It's certainly not worth it. It's better to let it go.
Successful bank, instead of helping consumers with mortgages,
people at the top of these firms chose to look away, to take more risk, to enrich themselves, and it is truly a crime.
What's our risk? Break it down.
$12 billion.
That's unacceptable.
But we have a real situation here. Our clients are about to jump ship.
The problem is saving this company, not the clients, this company.
We shifted $4 billion in deposits, which leaves us with $8 billion.
Until our clients figure out that we sold them worthless papers.
But that move only buys us a few more weeks at best.
I talked to Merrill. They said they'd insure the paper for 2 weeks, but they want $200 million to do it.
2 weeks. 2 weeks is nothing. We need 2 months at least. No. It's time for triage. It's time to dump the certificates on the market, all of them. Dump them.
What about the pension fund investors? We're talking over $15 billion here.
That's not our problem.
But if other houses follow suit, it could start a stampede.
Our priority is saving this house and fuck all the others. Our responsibility begins and ends with our partners and our shareholders, and that's it. Investors gamble, they lose. That's the risk that they agree to take, is it not? They don't complain when they make money on the market. Why should they complain when they lose money on the market? Shit happens. Now dump it. Dump it all right fucking now.
Even after we dump the stocks, we're still far too exposed, and we've got no parachute here.
I'm gonna take care of that. Charlotte?
Yes, Mr. Sanquist?
Set up a luncheon date for me with the Secretary of Treasury.
Will do.
Today.
Understood, sir. Today.
Thanks.
You heard Stancroft. He said the entire company's in jeopardy.
Yeah, with $51 million in his pocket. And you know as well as I do. This is bullshit. This is Stancroft and his fucking pissing contest with his goddamn partners.
I know what you're saying, but we don't really have a choice, do we?
All right, people, listen up.
All right, I've got some great news for you guys. In the next 3 days, we are going to increase your incentives by 3%. But I need you to get on the horn and get all your top clients and really push the Real Estate Growth Super Fund. As well, you will be receiving a memo in the next couple minutes detailing all the products that we need you guys to unload. You got me?
Whoever sells the most gets the largest bonus. All right, let's go, people.
Let's go. Let's move it.
Let's go. Sell those numbers. Sell, sell.
Hey, boy.
Hey,
The good news, as we can see here, is the tumors are completely gone. That's the good news.
Is bad news?
Not bad news, simply less than good news. The glands are still acting up, which is why we're seeing a recurrence of your symptoms.
But you got everything, right?
Yes. We see this on occasion. Even though the tumors are gone, the gland still acts out, as it were, as though the tumor was still there.
So what do we do?
Hormone injections once a week, that's the first thing. It's a tricky balancing act. We'll have to monitor your levels until we find the right mix. Also, your blood sugar level has skyrocketed. Again, as a result of the gland's reaction to the tumor, so we'll have to treat you for diabetes.
But she's gonna be all right.
Oh, yes. We just have a bit more ways to go to get you there. That's all.
What about,
We're planning on getting pregnant before the diagnosis.
At this particular time, it would be an extremely high-risk pregnancy, both for you and the baby. It's not something I could recommend. But once we get you to acceptable levels with treatment, which lowers the risk, then by all means, yes. There's a new gene therapy that certain patients have responded well to, which could get us to normalcy faster. It's a little on the experimental side, but I could...
Sun is up, Doc.
Yeah.
Excellent. The paperwork will be up front. And Rosie, I know it's difficult, but try hard to relax and not to worry. It only adds stress to your system, okay?
Thank you.
Thanks, Doc.
You're welcome.
It seems as if your coverage cap limit has been reached.
Coverage cap limit? What's that?
That's standard among many insurers. You really should call them. But regarding today, we'll need a payment before we can schedule another appointment.
Oh, okay. We can call in later then to reschedule. No. We'll call them.
It's fine. We'll use the card. I'm sure it's some kind of mistake. If I can get my wallet in my pocket. There you go. There.
Thank you. Sure, my card.
Am I sure?
Not really.
You can just call them.
So should we keep next Tuesday then? Does that work?
Yeah. Why don't you just call in and we can...
Okay.
Okay. Thank Thanks. You.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thanks.
This is the first time it's ever been mentioned to me. Now listen, I've been on the phone to you guys at least 100 times this year. Someone should have said something. I've been buried under a metric ton of paperwork from you guys ever since my wife got diagnosed. Now I can't be expected to catch every line of fine print from every letter. I work 6-7 days a week. I get that it's company policy, but that's got nothing to do.
Sorry, but there's nothing more we can do for you at this point.
So what you're saying is go fuck yourself, have a nice day.
Mr. Baxford, I apologize.
I sincerely doubt you're at all apologetic. You're not supposed to be, right?
Mr. Baxford, I'm very sorry.
It's useless.
Don't say that.
It is. I mean, I'm stuck here and I can't work and I'm sick all the time. And you've been working so hard.
I'm working for us.
Jim, I read the invoice and the hormone treatments, they cost $300 a shot. That's on top of all the other medication and then the gene therapy. They could be anywhere from 50 to 70,000. And if the insurance doesn't cover it...
We got the money.
Look, I can't let you spend our whole life savings.
Stop. Listen to me. We need the treatments. We need to get well. Once you get well, we can have our baby. And we can live the life we want to live, okay?
What are you doing?
What's it look like I'm doing?
Hey, we're not supposed to get pregnant yet.
We can practice.
Dude, that sucks. There's an actual coverage cap on the insurance. That means that there's really literally like a limit to how much you can spend on Rosie per month for medical?
Yeah. Basically, you read the fine print, it says if you get too sick and it's too expensive, they stop fucking paying.
Well, there goes the 3 heart attacks I was planning on having by the time I was 60. I guess if I get sick, I'd be better off swallowing my own gun.
Rosie's worried out of her fucking mind.
So what are you gonna do?
I got some money tucked away. Army disability, stuff like that. I'll call my broker.
I hear the market's shit right now, man. What are you invested in?
Structured notes. Whatever's safest.
Fuck, I hope so, bro.
I'll call him at lunch.
Lazy bastards, what'd you do? Just roll out of bed?
It's Jim Baxter.
Oh, no, second shift. Lunch for you, breakfast for us.
Just sit down and shut up. We already ordered for you.
It's easy.
John gets the cheeseburger. Jim?
Chili.
Cold chili. And he's always surprised, you know?
But always finishes.
Give me a couple of days, call the office.
All right.
I'd love to help you out.
I'll call you then. Oh, what's going on with my funds?
Jim, look, we gotta...
Hello?
I'm in a... I'll talk to you.
Hello?
That's what he meant. That's what he was thinking about.
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
Hey, man.
Fucking asshole.
What's up?
Who the hell was that?
My broker. Phone keeps dropping out.
Everybody's cheesed about their broker these days. Frank and me just learned that we have lost 20% of our pension. Dead and gone.
Gone. Like watery piss in the wind.
How?
I don't know. Bad investments on the part of idiots like us. You know, I should have went to some of those administration meetings.
Those meetings are bullshit. Our administrators do whatever's good for them. No matter how many people go to those goddamn meetings, it doesn't mean anything.
Collective bargaining, my ass. They should call it collective ball scratcher.
You know what me and Freddie do with our day? We bust homeless people for sleeping in the park. Or we cite some stupid schmuck for jaywalking. But the real fucking criminals, they're downtown, on Wall Street, wearing suits that cost more than any of us make in a year. And those motherfuckers steal more money than any asshole on Rikers Island ever dreamed of stealing. And if they get caught, which they won't get caught, but if they did, they get an ankle bracelet and get put under house arrest.
In their mansions, where the hookers come to you.
Yeah, and spend the night.
Well, the expensive kind of hookers that you want to spend the night. Wall Street hookers.
Wall Street. Bow, bow. Fuck those guys, you know what I mean? Fuck them.
You guys are doing a real good job of cheering my buddy up over here.
Oh, we're just talking shit, Jim. I'm sure you'll be all right.
Hey, fellows. Usual.
I didn't order fries.
It's all it. Around. Beef for you.
Where's my chili?
It's coming.
My fucking chili. It's all I eat is fucking chili. Make sure it's warm.
It's freezing cold.
Right.
I don't know why we come here. The food sucks.
But the site's good. At least it's warm.
That's true. How's Rosie doing, Jim?
She's hanging in there. It's been a tough year, you know? She's a fighter.
Give her our best.
Yeah.
She's a trooper, that one, Rosie. She's a good girl.
How's your wife?
Great. She's cheating on me.
What?
Here are your drinks. If you guys need anything else, just give me a holler.
What happened? You mean what happened? I'm a cop. I got married. It's inevitable.
It is.
How did you find out?
I read her text messages. Erotic reading, let me tell you.
What are you gonna do?
I'm torn. I don't know whether to beat the hell out of the son of a bitch, whoever he is, or to thank him from the bottom of my heart for keeping her occupied and off my back. It's a real conundrum here. And can we just talk about something else, huh? Talk about his girlfriend.
Who, yours? Him?
I heard in the news, and they were, talking about who you would want to have sex with, right? A, your wife, or B, before he could even answer, she could, nah. I fucked it up.
Husband and wife are laying in bed. The wife says to the husband, listen, when I die, would you get another woman in my bed? He says, yeah. She says, well, will you marry her? He says, maybe.
She says, will you let her use my golf clubs? He says, no, she's left-handed.
You guys wonder why you're divorced. We're getting divorced.
Hey, you know, you did it right, Jim. You didn't marry a cop's wife. You married a girl you actually love.
Yeah, I hear that. Yeah. She's a keeper, that Rosie, for sure.
Cheers to you guys.
Cheers.
Jim and Rosie.
Simon Johnson, could you highlight for our viewers the plutocratic capturing of American politics?
Well, there are several examples. Robert Rubin, co-chairman of Goldman Sachs, serves as Treasury Secretary under Clinton, and when he leaves, becomes chairman of Citigroup's executive committee. John Corzine, governor of New Jersey, head of MF Global. John Snow, Secretary of Treasury under Bush, leaves to become chairman of Cerberus Capital Management, a very large private equity firm that also has Dan Quayle among its executives. Alan Greenspan, head of the Federal Reserve, leaves to become a consultant for PIMCO, perhaps the world's largest player in the international
bond
market.
How are you feeling?
A little better.
A Treasury Secretary who is mostly responsible for deregulating financial derivatives and opening up that market, and then proceeds to make millions of dollars investing in hedge funds that invest in those very same derivatives that he deregulated. Henry Paulson, CEO of Goldman Sachs, leaves Goldman Sachs to join the Bush government as Secretary of Treasury with a $50 million...
I have a treatment tomorrow. Can you make it?
Absolutely.
And about the payment?
Baby, we gotta use the cards until we get this thing fixed.
Jim, they just raised the interest rate on the cards, and I've already put some bills
on
there, so...
Yeah, stop worrying.
Well, it's just you've been working so hard lately, you know, and...
You know, what choice do we have? I'm doing this for us.
You coming to bed?
In a minute. ...bailout program of $800 billion. Chris Dodd, chairman of the Banking Committee in the Senate, collected $13 million in campaign funds. Apparently, some of the government
held to the current state. See you next week.
Jim?
What the hell's going on?
Look, I'm sorry to tell you this, but your note's been delisted from the exchange.
Delisted? What does that mean?
There's an investigation going on right now.
Into what?
An investigation into some investment portfolios. But it looks like a significant portion of your fund was diverted into paper that is, well, a little suspect.
Meaning you don't know?
No, I don't. No one knows right now.
You're my broker. It's what you do. It's what you get paid for. How could you put my money into anything suspicious?
Jim, I told you when we first met, I only invest in clean deals, but it seems that the firm itself is behind all this. Look, I can't really tell you anything else. This thing is a legal snowball.
How is this possible?
Look, we'll just have to wait until the investigation is through, but it seems that your investment was good and as it should be, but then everything lost its value. But the question is, did the firm have knowledge that your original investment was bad?
You just said you only deal in clean deals.
I do, but I'm the player here, okay? Not the whole game. I mean, do I look happy to you? You're not the only one hurting because of this. Your investment, my investment, the investments of a lot of unfortunate
people. You told me, you promised me I'd make 8 to 10% of my investment, guaranteed.
Yeah, and that is what my firm told me. Look, I searched it out. I did my research. My office manager told me to put my clients into this.
What else did you put the money into?
Notes backed by commercial real estate. I mean, look, these looked like great buildings. I checked the specs. I did the research. They looked like they would be full capacity, okay? But now they're sitting...
Did you inspect these buildings? Did you inspect these properties?
The people that do all the research told me that this was the real deal.
So what do we do now?
You'll get some information regarding the investigation, and... Look, I'm telling you, it's going to take a while, though, before this whole thing is...
You're telling me I've lost all my money?
No, not necessarily. There's going to be some large lawsuits.
I just want my money back.
Jim, that's not how investment works. I mean, you got to pay to play.
This is not a fucking game, Dimmy. This is my fucking life savings, you fuck.
Look, I understand. Hey, I feel your pain. I do. I lost a lot of money, too. But that's how investment works, man. I'm sorry. It gives and it takes away.
Yeah, how are we doing with these sales?
We're at 20%.
20%? There's nothing wrong with that.
I totally agree. But the price is falling.
Oh, Jesus. Price falling to where? Nothing?
It's hard to tell right now, but our clients are starting to question our credibility.
Well, that's good. Some things never change. All right. You keep me posted.
I'm in here.
Sorry I'm late. I have to cover for one of the guys at work.
Everything okay?
Yeah, it's fine.
You know, you can tell me, you know.
I know.
The bank called.
It did? What'd they say?
I don't know. The machine picked it up. The message said that they needed you to call or get down there as soon as possible. Our mortgage, our interest rate, something like that. I mean, I was going to call.
I'll take care of the bank. Call him tomorrow.
And there's this.
It's from my broker.
Jim, what's going on?
Baby,
nothing's going on.
Please, you gotta stop worrying. let me take care of all the small stuff, all right? You need to get well.
Meaning no stress.
Okay. Look, I'm gonna go draw a bath and play some music, light some candles.
Light some candles?
Yeah. You should join me.
Okay. Jim, I don't know what to tell you.
Are you fucking kidding me? You're the one who said put my money in bullshit real estate. It says it right here that I am now liable for another 60 grand. Are you out of your fucking mind?
Jim, I told you, no one saw this coming.
I'm gonna sue you. I'm gonna fucking sue you.
Okay, just calm down, okay? We'll get to the bottom of this.
Sean, it's Jim. I need you to cover me for a couple of days.
No worries, man. More problems?
Yeah, something's come up.
Is Rosie okay?
No, she's fine. I gotta do a few things.
Okay, take care, buddy.
All right.
You invested and you lost. Now they want more money to cover expenses and losses. I'll file a lawsuit. Simple.
So I won't have to pay the 60 grand? I'll get my money back?
I'll make sure you don't have to pay the 60,000 or any of the interest they're laying on top of that. But your original investment, you'll have to talk to the ADA about that. I think EMR would join in that case.
Better fucking bet your life I will.
Now then. I work on a retainer basis, so I'll need $10,000 in advance to file a civil complaint.
$10,000. I ain't got $10,000.
No problem. Lots of lawyers work for cheap. Look, Jim, I'm not dealing with your investment. It looks like there has been a crime, and the DA's office is dealing with that. Now, if this is true, I'll be happy to assist you if you decide to sue for damages. But we have to start by filing this complaint for injunctive relief to protect you from the $60,000 demand and the interest it is going to accumulate.
I only got $1,500.
I'm sorry, Jim, but I'm looking over 40 hours of work on your case. Come back when you got the 10 grand. That's my minimum. You could borrow the money or get a credit card, but that's the best I can do. Somewhat ironically, unlike investing, with attorneys, you usually get what you pay for.
I'll see what I can do.
Call me, or not.
You all right?
Yeah, hanging in.
Hey, is that back door supposed to be open? How you been, man?
Hey, what's up, man?
Any holdups today?
All right. Same old shit, different day.
It's unfucking believable. They expect you to pay 60 grand now?
Yeah. It's happening all over. I lost 18,000 in the mutual fund. College money for my son.
Yeah, my folks lost their nest egg.
You fucked.
What? You don't have $60,000?
What do you fucking think?
You got family you could borrow from?
Not an option. Look, I'm tapped out, but I could scratch up a few bucks.
Yeah, we could take up a collection from the guys.
I'm just gonna refuse to pay it. We gotta get to the job.
Lunch is on me, all right? Allow me.
Thanks, guys. I appreciate it. Look, hang in, man. It can only get better.
Yeah.
Change?
That's for you, sweetie.
Thanks.
Later.
Jim. I got 10 grand I can loan.
Forget it.
Please, Jim. Listen
Sean,
to me, man.
Forget about it.
Look, I don't have a girlfriend. I don't have a family. I don't have anything, okay? Please, let me help you out. It would mean a lot to me.
Might take you up on that. Pay this lawyer.
Just hang in there.
It's called an adjustable rate for a reason. When the housing market changes, so do the interest rates. That's how that
Listen,
works.
Listen, my premiums have doubled in the blink of an eye. I'm not going to be able to keep up with this rate.
Yeah, you got a favorable deal when you signed, the terms of which was at a specified point in time. The interest rate would reflect the market.
Can we refinance?
Well, your net worth has taken a significant hit over the last few days, and your wife, she hasn't worked for a year or so, right?
Yeah, she got sick.
Yeah, I'm sorry to hear that. But in light of all of that, refinancing wouldn't be prudent for our bank at this time.
So you're shafting me?
Oh, no, it's not me. It's the guidelines handed down from above. If it was up to me, I would help you out. You could always try to sell your house.
I sell my house in this market.
I'm sorry, I don't know what else to tell you. You could declare bankruptcy. A lot of people do that.
Fuck you.
That's a fair response, I suppose.
Hey.
Hey.
You at the bank?
Yeah.
Well, what was it about?
Like I said, don't worry about it. All right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Good.
you'd have no problems coming up with this.
I got it from a friend. Hope this works.
It will. And then I'll see if we can find other investors who got burned on this and put together a collective lawsuit.
Collective ball scratching.
What's that?
It's just a joke. Not funny, I guess.
Don't underestimate the power of a large group when it comes to asking for damages.
Hope so. So what do we do about this letter demanding 60 grand?
I'll contact the other party. I will let them know I am your attorney and that you will not be paying.
Then what?
You know, there may be another way out of this. You take the fall on this, but it could end all this drama for you instantly.
What do you have in mind?
Would you be willing to write off your initial investment and walk away if these guys let you out of the 60,000?
Should I?
Something you should consider. It could be years before the real estate market bounces back. If for some reason I can't get the court to grant injunctive relief to stop these guys, you could wind up paying years of interest on this claim against you.
This motion, it's gonna work, right?
Most likely. But nothing in law is for certain. I'm just offering this as an option. But if they're willing to let you play ball and back off, then you can put it all behind you. Be nice, huh? Okay, don't think about it for too long. Time to act is now.
Let me think about it.
You just paid me. I can either file the complaint as planned, or I can try and negotiate directly with them. But I need to do one or the other.
I need a day.
Half a day would be better.
All right. I got a meeting with the assistant district attorney today.
Oh, yeah, good. I put that in the letter.
Thanks.
Let me know what happens.
I'm sorry, Mr. Baxford. I'm sure I double-checked the schedule when you called, but unfortunately, it seems that Mr. Marwood doesn't have time for you in his schedule today.
I called three times.
I'm sorry. I can leave him a message if you'd like.
Well, maybe you can answer a few questions for me.
I'm afraid that I wouldn't be any help with anything. I'm not even a legal secretary. I'm just an assistant.
Just the assistant. Is that your excuse? Do you have any idea what's going on here? You heard my name at all?
No, I'm sorry, sir. No, I don't.
Myra, call me, please.
I'm sorry, Mr. Baxford.
I need to speak to you.
Mr. Marwood is extremely busy. Please, I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
I need to speak
to him. Don't make me have to call security.
I am security, you fucking bitch. Get your fucking hands off me.
So,
how did it go today?
Pastor didn't have time for me.
He had an appointment, man.
Yeah.
You gonna be okay?
You have reached the voicemail of Patterson Law Group. Please leave a message after the tone.
These bastards, they never answer their fucking phones.
Hey, about the money, seriously, don't even worry about paying me back. Ain't no thing but a chicken wing, man.
Appreciate that. I've done everything. I went to the DA, I've been to the lawyer. Fucking banks.
System's rigged, motherfucker. Come on. on. You know that shit.
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
Let's go get some alcohol. Make the pain go away.
Perhaps the best example of how this all works is in the AIG bailout. When AIG went bankrupt,
listen, lady, I've left him a ton of messages, a ton. He's the guy in charge of prosecuting the brokerage houses, right?
Yes, that's one of many cases.
Well, I need to speak to him urgently, like right now.
100 cents on the dollar was paid to the Goldman Sachs debtors. When a firm goes bankrupt, you don't expect to get 100 cents on the dollar because it's a bankrupt firm. It can't pay its debts. By Wall Street protests, a few thousand people. I do not understand why the American people are not up in arms about this. These are criminal acts. This is blatant fraud and conflict of interest. What's being done? There is no government investigation. No one has been arrested. No charges have been laid. No one's even looking into it. And yet all the information is there in the open. These are criminals walking in our midst. And now the banks want to have the same piece of faith that we have in our government. The banks have been trading with ideas. They just have derivatives and swaps that move back and forth. This has to stop. It can't go on. We have to underpin our dealings with actual wealth, not pieces of paper that are simply ideas from rich men.
Baby?
Hey.
What are you doing here? You got treatment this morning, right?
I know, I canceled it.
You what?
Our cards, they declined last time. And the debt people, they've been calling the house, so I called the bank and I know what's going on. We're broke, aren't we? We had all of our money in that fund and it's gone, isn't it? Jim. Jim, it's okay. I understand you. You're just protecting me. It'll be okay.
I'm gonna get the money back. I'm gonna fix this.
God, this has been so hard on you. You're getting gray hair and wrinkles all because of me.
It's gonna be all right. You're gonna be all right.
No, I'm not. But it's okay. I wanted us to have a baby. You know, I know that he would look just like you, and I couldn't wish for anything more.
Baby, don't say that. We're gonna sell the house.
Jim. It'll be okay. It's...
Call my lawyer. Jim Baxford for Mr. Patterson. One
moment, please. Jim, how's it going?
I got a letter here saying they're gonna foreclose on us, and the bank's cutting us off, all because of this bullshit real estate.
Look, Jim.
You offered to waive my investment if I knocked off the 60 grand.
Well, I think that would've worked, but you didn't give me an answer in time. If I could have gotten them earlier, I would.
I called you back the same fucking day.
At the end of a long Friday after 4 p.m., if I remember correctly. That means I didn't get back to them until Monday or Tuesday. I have my message logs.
What about this motion you filed? The relief thing?
The broker you invested with went bankrupt, and their assets were purchased by another company. There's no one to file a motion against right now. Since the broker's in bankruptcy, you need to hire a bankruptcy attorney to lift a thing called an automatic stay. It's really a pain in the ass.
What about the real estate company? What about that?
Well, they're also under protection of the bankruptcy court and the automatic stay. It's part of the bankruptcy law that says you can't take any action against a company in bankruptcy without first hiring another lawyer and getting permission for the bankruptcy court. It's complicated.
Why didn't you tell me this before? Why the fucking are you?
I haven't heard from you in 2 weeks and certainly wasn't privy to the inner financial workings of these companies. The bankruptcy filings were just as much a surprise to me. So let me give you my best advice. Pay the 60 grand. I'll file the same injunctive relief motion we talked about to try and prevent you from having to pay the accumulated interest. And I won't ask for any more money from you for me. How's that sound?
I don't have 60 grand.
Jim, I'll get this one. Call me later this afternoon.
It's so my fault.
It's not your fault.
No, I got sick and it put us in debt.
It's not your fault. It's the banks, it's the CEOs, it's the fucking brokers.
Jim, I hate what this is doing to you. I'm sorry.
I gotta go to work.
Jim.
Andy, you wanted to see me?
Yeah, come on in. Close the door, please. Jim, we've been contacted by a couple of lawyers and collection agencies in the last couple of days. It seems that you have a lot of debts.
It's not what you think. Ever since Rosie got sick, things have been
getting... They got a judgment against you. A lien to garnish your wages on a monthly basis.
How much?
You keep 800 per month.
Let me speak to my lawyer before you give these guys anything.
We're not going to give them anything because... Jim, I'm sorry, but we're going to have to let you go.
We cannot have employees that are having financial troubles protecting our money.
You get what I mean? We're a bonded firm. We'll lose our insurance. We'll lose our clients. We just can't have you working here, not under these conditions. Think of how it looks. Man, it's not good. Severance.
What about my insurance? You know Rosie's been sick.
You can do Cobra on the insurance.
That's 600 a month. How can I keep her alive on that?
The check is your official severance. But we owe you back pay, overtime. You put in a lot of hours and you've been a loyal employee. So instead of a check, I had them issue it in cash. With a bit of a bump, 9,000. Cash is better, I figure. Banks and collections will never know. Just between us.
I appreciate that.
And I'm gonna need your weapon and employee ID too.
Man, listen, I'm sorry.
I didn't know.
Thank you.
right now. Just leave a message. Have a good day.
Hey, Jim, what's up? It's Sean. Look, man, I didn't know what was gonna happen, all right? I'm really sorry. I love you, bro. Please give me a call.
God visits us with many mysteries in life. Unexpected death is the most challenging. But when it happens, when God leaves us speechless in the face of death, he reminds us that all we have is forgiveness. We must set our anger aside and look to those whom we have lost to found a better life. For who is God except the Lord? And who is a rock besides our God? The God who girdles me with strength and made my way safe. He made my feet like the feet of a deer and set me secure on the heights. He trains my hands for war so that my arms can bend a bow of bronze. You have given me the shield of your salvation, and your right hand has supported me. Your help has made me great. You gave me a wide place for my steps under me, and my feet did not slip. I pursued my enemies and overtook them, and did not turn back until they were consumed. I struck them down so that they were not able to rise. They fell under my feet, for you girded me with strength for the battle. You made my assailants sink under me. You made my enemies turn their backs to me, and those who hated me, I destroyed.
Hi, you've got Jim and Rosie. We're not home right now, but leave a message and we'll call you right back.
Hey, Jim. It's Sean. You're not answering your cell. Are you all right?
I don't really know what to say, but I'm just thinking of you, bro.
I hope you're okay. I love you. Please call.
Hi, you've got Jim and Rosie. We're not home right now, but leave a message and we'll call you right back.
Hey, Jim, it's Fred and Frank. Listen, but we'd love to get together for lunch sometime. Or come over some night, watch the game, do some serious drinking. We miss you, pal.
Well done, guys. Well done. It was an excellent meeting. Thank you to my lovely secretary for being working so hard.
I think after last week.
What do you think?
Mr. Marwood.
Mr. Marwood is extremely busy. Mr. Marwood is extremely busy.
It's lovely. There's so much possibilities out there. If you don't take advantage of them, you just throw away. Well, maybe it's time for some of us to stumble home. You guys have a good weekend. You deserve it. Hello, John.
What?
Oh, come on, John. It's too late for that stuff. No, I really don't want to talk about this right now. Can you just please call me tomorrow morning? All right, thank you.
Mr. Marwood, I'm Jim Baxford.
Yeah.
I left you a bunch of messages, 20 to be exact.
I'm off the clock, you know, if you want to talk.
I lost my life savings. My house, my job, my wife.
Look, Jim, it is not my fault that your wife left you, all right? I'm sorry.
She didn't leave me. She's dead.
Oh, for fuck, come on, man.
I'm telling you.
Just get off of me.
Economic collapse. The poll found that this belief in the fragility of the American economy cuts across the entire political spectrum. For decades, America has been enjoying unprecedented economic growth, but unfortunately,
that growth was fueled by a mountain of debt, and now those bills are starting to come due. As the economic collapse intensifies, opinions vary on how to stop the downward spiral. Call this crisis by any name you want, it's the same old game. The rich still get richer, and the poor get poorer.
Thank you, everyone, and good night from New York News 7.
Talk to me.
So it looks great. We got rid of everything.
That's great. Fantastic. And you think that's going to be enough?
Absolutely. I think the bank will look great, but our clients, not so much.
Okay. It's the only play we had, so we got this is a shot we took, and we took it, and it's looking good. Am I right?
Yeah, you were right all along.
Okay. Well, you know, that's what I like to hear, you know?
Standard & Poor's are private. They can destroy companies and even countries with financial rating downgrades. They can effectively alter exchange rate
mortgage held in breath for the last several weeks, waiting to see if the airline crib...
Sun Standard is the latest Wall Street firm to receive federal money to stay afloat while they are
behind what we're doing. And the question then becomes, are we going to be able to deliver for them?
Like many other financial institutions,
$7.7 trillion in undisclosed loans were made by the Federal Reserve to struggling financial institutions.
They are going to be watching very carefully. And there are those who believe that government doesn't have a role to play.
I want to be very clear. I take full responsibility for the decisions that I made and for the actions that I took.
J.P. Morgan Chase won. It will assume $31 billion in WAM losses.
The loans came with virtually no strings attached.
However, eventually the bottom dropped out sharply and suddenly, leaving investors with little.
Meeting with Secretary Olson for a federal arrest.
That didn't happen. The government stepped in and held one of its own.
Raven continued to squander billions.
Yes, all
the same time, the Chinese government looks to use these events to negotiate more favorable terms with its partners around the globe.
Hi, you've got Jim and Rosie. We're not home right now, but leave a message and we'll call you right back.
Mr. Baxford, it's Walt from the bank calling. We've sent you letters and left you numerous messages about your mortgage default. As per our conversation the other day, the bank has no choice at this time but to foreclose on your home. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me.
Hi, you've got Jim and Rosie. We're not home right now, but leave a message and we'll call you right back.
I'm not answering the phone no more. So stop fucking calling. I don't want to talk to you.
Mr. Baxford! James Baxford! James Baxford? Notice of eviction due to foreclosure.
You like doing this? Kicking people out in the street?
Sorry, sir. To sign this document and pack up your things. You will have 48 hours to vacate the premises. Sir, if you and your belongings are not out of here in 48 hours, the sheriff will be here to remove you forcibly, so you should sign this.
Take this piece of paper and shove it up your ass.
That's fine, Mr. Baxford. You've been legally served.
no loud music. And that's not working. Take the stairs.
Speaking of work, how's Jim?
I don't know. Give him a call. See how he's doing.
It's been on my mind lately. Sean.
Hey, Jim.
We've been thinking about you. Here, I'm gonna put you on speaker, okay?
Hey, man. We miss you at lunch.
Yeah, you should come join us, Jim.
I need more time, guys. A little more time. Look, you take all the time you need. We just want you to know that we're all there for you.
Yeah, don't run away from us. We're gonna help you get back on your feet.
I really appreciate that, guys. I'll see you soon.
Right.
All right, man.
Jim, bye.
These are the two pieces you were asking about. Did you bring the dollars? Looks good. So where'd you serve?
10th. Keith Stack referred me.
Stack's a good soldier.
Yeah.
Here, don't forget your clips. Hey, I gotta ask you. You in any way, shape, or form associated with law enforcement?
I know, cop. I'm just a private citizen concerned about his own personal safety, all right?
Yeah.
Grenades?
Oh, yeah, I got two left. Shrapnel.
How much?
I'll sell you both for a Hunsky. For personal protection?
For fun.
Grenades are fun. You take it easy.
Thank you. asshole.
Recapping our top story, the vice president of a well-known brokerage firm was gunned down as he walked to his car. The killing appears to have been targeted. Our correspondent is at the scene with an update.
Thank you. This is a developing story. There are no suspects at this time. However, it is believed the victim may have been targeted because of his involvement in the financial sector. Police are looking for clues, and a spokesman for them released a statement earlier today saying they're treating this as...
A majority of American voters now believe that the United States could experience a total economic collapse.
Various types of loans became available to consumers who happily assumed an unprecedented debt.
Sun Standard is the latest Wall Street firm to receive federal money to stay afloat while they look...
It's about morality, and we can't let these guys win. And also, ultimately, we want our money back from the United States government. They gave the bank bailouts. We want our...
Brothers in bankruptcy billed over $850 million in legal fees, in addition to billing in costs for massages and lobster dinners. Around 20 lawyers made over $40 million each before the people who actually lost money got in.
The really amazing thing here is that the government awarded them the contract in the first place without making sure to place a cap on these costs.
The people are angry, and rightly so.
Find out in our full report right after the break.
These institutions had also assumed significant debt.
This speculation drove the value of the fund up.
Charlotte, are you reading this? Let's get some personal security in this office for me right now.
Of course.
You gotta be kidding me.
Hey, look at
Jess.
This.
What up, man?
Hey.
How you doing, man?
Dude.
Good. How you doing?
Good, man. How you feeling?
Yeah, good.
Hey,
good
to see you. Good to see you. How you doing, man? You all right?
Yeah, I'm good.
Better?
Yeah, good. I got lunch.
Oh, good. Come on, man. You don't have to do that.
I just fucking did.
Aww.
I miss you guys.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. She too.
Lunch hasn't been the same. So what's been going on?
A lot. You know, I've just been hanging.
Working?
I ain't been working. It's tough, you know. Rosie gone and shit. It's not good, but, you know, it is what it is. Anyway, so, I'm moving.
Moving? Where to?
I don't know. From city, different state. I gotta get out of here. Everywhere I go, I keep seeing Rosie. You know, it's driving me nuts. You get it, right?
I get it.
Yeah, hell, I understand. I feel like doing the same thing sometimes.
Your wife hasn't left you?
No, I don't know why the hell she doesn't just go. It's a mystery to me.
What are you talking about? She fucking loves you.
Oh. Yeah, she loves me. She loves you. She loves everybody in the neighborhood. That's the problem.
She hasn't bailed on him yet.
She loves me, I bet.
Oh.
Yeah. You gotta tell us where you're going, all right?
Absolutely. Besides, it's a good time for me getting out of here with all these fucking shootings, huh?
Mm. Yeah, it's a hell of a thing. The whole city's on alert. Look at that.
Yeah, Nebraska's afraid it's gonna escalate.
Really? I'll get him soon enough.
They better. Nebraska's screaming.
Whoever it is. Really fucking hates rich bankers, which only leaves us a million suspects.
You know, whoever does catch this guy's gonna get a big promotion, my man.
Well, in that case, I'll save you the trouble.
The fuck are you talking about?
It's me.
Okay, you had me going there for a minute, all right?
I'm serious.
Come on, man, you give me a heart attack. Cut it out. What's the matter with you?
All right, who got the Reuben?
Always with your finger, huh? Sorry. Look at where her fingers have been. You don't want that. I'm gonna get an STD from this sandwich.
Oh, shut up.
I'm not. You ruined it for me. I'm serious. I'm afraid to eat my sandwich now. I'll get a herpes. You should put a condom on your finger. That's what you should do. I think she's been going to the gym. You know that? Did you notice that? I think she's been going to the gym.
Wife's ready to pop. Oh, I got him a membership to our country club. It's like 90,000 plus.
That's crazy.
You bet you.
You're crazy. That's too much money.
Hey, did you hear Stan Cross shot the same one? That guy really It's going to last the game. She is really cute.
Yeah.
Look at the balloons together.
Hey, Robert. It's Jim. Jim Baxford.
Jim Baxford. Hey, it's good. It's good to see you.
You too.
I hope you recovered from that little financial disaster of ours.
Not quite, but I'm getting there.
Well, it was a tough time, man. We all took a loss. I mean, when I told my wife we couldn't vacation in Barbados, she tore a strip off me the size of Long Island. But things get better, right?
Right. That's what everyone keeps telling me.
Well, trust me, it's true. Look, I'll give you my new business card. Somewhere here. There we go. I got a couple of investment ideas you might be interested in. I'll take you for lunch next week, huh?
Yeah.
I gotta run. It was good to see you.
Yeah, you too.
Yeah, call me.
Shot. They deserved it. There's no effective laws in this country anymore. You get 5 years for robbing a gas station. You destroy America, steal $20 trillion, and you walk away?
Well, violence is not the solution, Gus.
Why not? Isn't violence the official solution of our government in Iraq, Afghanistan?
Okay, thanks for your comments, Gus. Caller, who's on the line?
This is Brian. Why'd you cut Gus off? I think he's right. I lost my house and Wall Street's getting a free ride for some reason. Why is Richard's phone still a free man? I hope he gets a vote next.
Okay, that's all the time we have on today's show for call-in. Let's have a look at today's market. The U.S. dollar is trading at 1.31 against the...
Listen to me, we've been going over this again and again. It's not
about the money. He's not delivering on the pitch. Week in and week out, he did.
Robert here.
Hey, Robert. It's Jim.
Jim, yeah, how you doing?
You're not gonna fucking believe this, but I won 50 G at the poker tournament.
Shit, yeah, that's great.
Fucking unbelievable. Anyway, I need some advice on what to put it in.
I got a hot new fund.
Oh, great. Well, how about we have a coffee?
The place near my office.
Yeah, same coffee shop.
Okay.
Tomorrow.
Yeah.
9 o'clock.
That sounds great.
All right. See you then.
Yeah, but you see 856, that's got to jump up to 95. No, look at the right screen. No, we got to sell those shares right away. Well, no, we got to drop those shares, bump up the other side. We need more points on that side.
Shit.
I'm not the boss
Be
here.
Quiet. You have absolutely no say in this.
Please, my wife, she's pregnant.
Who's that guy with Smith? Maggie, get a hold of security now. Hey, what the fuck is going on?
Get back to your wife and be thankful, you prick. Get the fuck out of here. Go!
Copy that. 38th floor. 38th floor.
Police are looking into whether or not today's shooting spree has anything to do with the recent murders. Now, from what we know, all the victims were involved in the brokerage scandals, but there was a question of whether their fraud charges could be prosecuted. We know that the shooter is still in the building at the moment.
Get out of here. Out. Get out.
Whatever it is you want, this is not the way to get it.
Take a fucking seat. Right there. Sit the fuck down. Bet you've never seen your desk from that angle before.
I don't know who it is you think I am, but... you know, whatever it is you want, this isn't going to accomplish anything.
Did I tell you to speak? You want to know the difference between a banker and a gangster? A gangster always has a getaway plan.
Okay.
And by the way,
I know exactly who you are. You're the guy that fucks everyday people in the ass so you can float around on your yacht when you're not sitting in your fucking house in the Hamptons. Or booking tennis lessons from your penthouse overlooking Central Park.
How do you know all this?
I've been watching you.
problem with guys like you is you can't stop bragging. So when the rest of the world is suffering, you're making sure that every magazine in the country knows all about your triumphs.
Well, you know, there are people that derive inspiration from success stories. You know, maybe you'd do all the same things I've done if you had the opportunity.
No, I wouldn't. I wouldn't sell bad loans to people with small amounts of money. You make yourself real cash-based and fabricated non-existent loans. You cook the books to get your bonuses. That's what you fucks do. But the question is, why should I let you live? You're a salesman, right? Sell me.
Sell you. You know, there's not a person on this earth that's worth over $100 million that came by that money honestly. Why don't you take a look at the old money, the Vanderbilts, the Carnegies, the Gettys, the Morgans, the Hearsts, the Rockefellers. How do you think they got all that money? They just annexed territories and licenses and businesses and killed the native population and imported slaves and sold guns to both the North and the South during the Civil War and controlled the politicians and their heroes, their American heroes.
Team 5 on 38. Civilians coming down. Proceeding to locate target.
We teach our children what? Honesty and hard work are the keys to success. And my children are not going to go off to some war. They're going to go to Yale. They're going to go to Harvard. And it's going to be the dumb, stupid, white trash kids and the black ghetto kids that are going to, they're going to fight America's senseless wars. And they're going to protect American security and businesses. And it's going to be my business. My business is going to get richer and richer. And my bonuses are going to get bigger and bigger. And it's the same old story. It's the bankers and the owners and the advisors who get rich. And it's the little people who buy their stock that always lose in the end. To people like you.
Some people don't recover. People like me.
That's a free trade system, my friend. That's capitalism. That's competition in a capitalist society. That's how the cream always rises to the top. That's how the strong survive and the weak die off.
Like her? That's my wife you're looking at. She's dead because of you.
For fuck's sake. I don't know you. I have never seen you before in my life.
But you do know about the real estate growth superfund, don't you?
That's where you put your money.
Your company sold it to me.
For the commissions. For the commissions. That's how it works.
You like competition?
I love competition.
You want to play a little free market competition? Just you and me?
You and me? I can't wait.
One weapon, two guys, winner lives. On the count of three. One, two.
Wow, looky here how I came out on top.
Cheated.
That's what you don't understand. That's not what's important. What's important is that I won. It doesn't matter how I won. And you're dead.
I cheated too.
Claire! Get him out of here!
Target located and eliminated.
Thank you.
I'm still alive and free, and I promise I will keep killing. They should all know that I am out there, a soldier of the people. And if the government, the prosecutors, and the judges fail in their duty, I will not fail in mine.